seems to be, from my view, a lot of lopsided reaction. It's more in favor of what are we going to do about the landlord? What are we going to do about the pit bulls? And what are we going to do about how the family's going to react to losing their pit bull? And I can sympathize with all that reaction. And there's going to be hardship, regardless of what way the ruling goes. But the thing is that the case that came before the court that made this decision come up didn't happen to be a beagle. And if it was one beagle, it probably wouldn't have made the decision even come this far, because it was only one beagle. There are enough situations on the record that shows that pit bulls have this aggressive nature. I'm not here to tell you that all pit bulls will attack. I'm not here to tell you that there might be some that never attack. I have a sister-in-law who has a pit bull, has had one for 10 years. I have no incident with that pit bull. But we have to be mindful of the fact that they do have that capability. And because they have the potential to be that aggressive, it does not mean that I want a pit bull bashing mission here. We just have to be recognizing the fact that it does exist, and there are enough situations on the books that mandate that. And if any other dog has a pattern of committing that kind of damage or inflicting that kind of damage, then by all means, put them on the list as well. I'm all for strict liability for all dog owners, but we have to give them a means for being responsible. We just can't say, let's put all dog owners responsible. If they don't have the insurance to cover you, it falls on the victim. Their victims do not have a voice in the situation. I did not have a right, all right, they have a right to own whatever dog they want to own, but it was at my expense. And yes, we can all sympathize. I don't want to see anybody lose their dog, but I almost lost my son that day. And that's something that needs to be recognized loud and clear. Because I'm the one who had to see my son in that alley. That did not symbolize a dog attack. It was not what I was familiar with seeing and representing with a typical dog attack. This looked like a shark attack. And not every dog, no matter how bad the dog owner is going to be able to inflict that kind of damage. I don't care how many dogs you put before you. You can put whatever the ruling will be. If you make the strict liability to all dogs, the pit bulls are going to still top the list of what's going to happen. Because I am a mortgage underwriter. I've seen many rental leases where landlords already do not allow certain dog breeds or pets at all because they don't want to deal with the consequences. And we cannot turn a blind eye anymore and say it's all on the dog owner, or let's just teach our children better. That's like telling your child, I have a loaded gun in the cabinet. Whatever you do, don't open it up. Now, are you going to walk out of the house and leave that child unattended and believe that they're never going to open up that drawer? We can't tell our children, just walk away from the dog, don't run, don't kiss its face, and think that's going to be enough. It's not enough. The measures are so extreme, and there's more than just this one incident on the books that shows that there's a pattern, that something more extreme has to happen to address this issue. Because it's falling on the victims, it fell on my family. There's no victims fund that I was able to go to. And the dog owner, they walked away from the situation, and the landlord walked away from the situation. And if it needs to be a strict liability for all dogs, whatever is deemed dangerous, I'm not just here to say it's only the pit bulls. I know there are other dangerous dogs out there. Then they also need to be on that list, and it needs to be recognized. And if it is for all dogs, you probably will still see the same dogs that are on that list right now, that are before the courts right now. It's going to still be the same dogs. You're not going to see beagles stop on the list, even if you make it all dogs. You know, it's not all Yorkies and poodles or whatever. They're not going to, they'll nip. And yeah, all dogs can bite. We can all agree on that. We can all agree it makes it worse when you have a bad dog owner. But not all dogs will do the same thing, will have the same damage. And because of this, we need to recognize this problem, and it needs to be addressed aggressively as the situations and the circumstances that we have. Thank you.